Tell me about what happened on that day with the president.
Well, it was 1 year ago, today. It was the 7th of June, 2012. The president called everyone for an urgent meeting in the White House. He hadn't told us what the meeting was about, but we all felt the tension in the air.
The tension?
No, the tension. That had been away. Haven't changed, had much to say. But man, I still think them cats are crazy. They were asking if you were around, how you was, where you could be found. Told them you were living downtown, driving all the old men crazy. The boys are back in town, the boys are back in town. Who were that?
Everyone. By that, I mean each and everyone. Nuclear weapons ready, sir.
Mr. President, I will say that we nuke them, and we nuke them now.
You can't be serious about this. We're talking World War III here. Do you know about the consequences this could have? This could mean the end of the world as we know it.
Of course I know about the consequences. How dare you speak to me like that? Of course I understand. Don't you understand that I understand?
Hold your tongue, gentlemen. Fire. That guy.
These bombs hit several important military outposts in both Russia and China. We had the necessary information, but then it all went wrong. And then all hell broke loose.
Trying to explain the mistake to the public.
Yes, but it was all too late. The media had already painted their own picture.
Good evening. Today several American nuclear warheads have destroyed a large number of military outposts in both China and Russia. Earlier today, the US president had called for an important meeting with the head of the US military and government. We had gotten reports from yet unconfirmed sources that this attack had been planned for over a year.
We are now going over to our correspondents around the world to receive more information. First, over to Vladimir Over to Vladimir.
Привет. Je desh viroji, vejoshoke poshe, sobtiv tvoroy. Polodnie dnia. Sjeszczas jest obażenia mnogich grażdina ja znaju, što jazyk zgodnat matrawia, mirowania wojna może biżet, o wożduke, prezydent zgodnia weżrą wyzwojem, puty.
I'm sorry, I think we misunderstood you.
Oj! I dziwnie jeszcze, on jajlia se, że ja zgodnia rzeczajno, preskonferencji. Samo on bude kožina baranaju voj. Kožuru etogo I žonoreškogo puti.
Okay, thank you. We might get back to you in a later news broadcast. We now have our Chinese correspondent online. How is the tension in the country right now?
Tadi kunjai, zhang zheng zhong jie, zhong ling bang wa ji, nong zhen zhuo, zai zhen jie e wa zhang.
How bad is the damage made in the country, and how has the government reacted to the American attack?
We
thank Rishong Dingdong from China And what now, Martin?
Well, thank you, Philip. And we're going inland to a famous war anthropologist from Texas who will explain more about what's going on and what will eventually could lead to. Over to Billy Bob Johnson. Oh, we're really sorry for that. Do we have you online now, Billy Bob Johnson? Can you hear us?
Howdy, partner. I hear you loud and clear.
Can you please explain more about the current situation in the world?
Well, that's my grandma Roo. Here down in Austin, Texas, it's 55 degrees and I got my whole soul there and he's down in the sound of the grandma zoo. This can't be serious. This ramblin' thing is affecting my life too. Yee-haw!
Considering the situation, do you think a third world war is avoidable?
Well, it's lemon dirty. It was in the fall of 1982. I was on watching the telefederator when our catastrophhy flies of McFruby came singing along. I began reading the telefeder, but I can't say what it stood. But it be rude, ling-a-ling-ding. Shit house lemon deck, it's lemon you. So feed you, feelin' do you not. Reasons to tell. One thing's clear, you's not filthy for this comprehension, but the onion will be scrambled. Faster than two hands in the whole house. But who then? Who put the bomb a bump in the bump a bump bang bomb? Who put the ram in the lamma lamma ding dong? Yeah, probably the same put the bippity 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 dippity dip.
The situation doesn't really seem to be good.
No, not at all. And the big question every news station is asking themselves now is, how do the big countries react to all this, and will they go into this growing world debate? We'll go directly to our correspondents in Europe. Can you hear us, Günther Bomberhansen?
Hallå Newsstudio och den Nachrichtstudio, wie man sagt hier in Berlin. Vi bauen derzeit eine neue Berliner Mauer zum Schutz. Angela Merkel hat auch bereits begonnen, einsperren das deutsches Geld, sodass wir mit einem möglichen Bombenanschläge gegen uns hier in Europas wichtiges Land mehr standhalten konnten. Geld ist super wichtig. Bombe Griechenland stattdessen ist das Motto.
Are there any plans for a counterattack in case of an attack in Europe?
Ja, natürlich. Unsere Kohlekraftwerke untrieben bunt, mehr militärisches Gerät herzustellen. Deutsche Menschen lieben Blitzanfälle. Tod nach Griechenland, weil sie unser Geld nahm während der Krise.
Well, thanks for now, Günther. And by that, we'll go directly to Germany's neighbor, France. Bonjour, Mademoiselle Claude Petit-Henri.
Bonjour, Kianki. La France est pour moi le top baguette. Tout un commun à amour de baguette pour l'hiver nucléaire.
What does Sarkozy say about the upcoming confrontation between China, Russia and USA?
Sarkozy a pris la fuite avec le cocon à son maison d'été sur la Riviera. Il est prévu de commencer pour la décision sur les collaborations pactes si quantistes suffisamment d'années.
Merci, beaucoup, Claude. We also want to talk to our English correspondent, Charles Oliver Scones.
I'm having my evening tea and biscuits, but I suppose you want to know about the state on the streets. Well, the public is out of its minds tonight, and the crowd surrounding Buckingham Palace is perplexed. And quite questioning what's going on. To be frank, I believe the ongoing situation is kind of queer.
If you compare the capitalistic situation during the World War II to now, is there the same kind of tension in the air tonight?
Well, you see, then, it was a war and now we are not quite there yet. So I recommend you must not panic. We Englishmen are quite steel next, you see. We wouldn't see the war if it was coming for us. Tonight, the overall situation in the country is calm and we gentlemen will have a celebration for the best English cricket player in the world throughout history, who this night would have been 300 years old. Long live Lord Young Philip Sackville and Her Majesty, or Ancient Queen Elizabeth.
Thank you very much indeed, Sir Charles. Do we have anything more on this subject for now, Philip?
Well, actually, for once we have our African correspondent, Olufo Banana, with us from the deepest jungle. Can you hear us, Olufo? We can't quite hear you. Could you please peel your banana, Olufo? Yes, can you repeat what you said? So, nothing has happened in Africa. Okay, but how has the not-so-bright crowd in Africa reacted to a chaotic situation in the world? Thank you, Lufu, for your helpful words.
And that's all from our world correspondents. Now over to Mr. Sunshine and the weather.
Thank you. Here in New York there will be some good weather. You can expect somewhere between 50 to 70 degrees. Moving down further to Washington, you can expect probably the same as in New York, but a bit more cloudy. Moving down even more further south to Philly, you should bring an umbrella. If you are in Miami, there's no need to fear the weather. The sun will shine all day. In the heart of our country, Kansas City days, is a cloudy but a bit chance of sunshine. Moving on further west to the city of Angels, Los Angeles. A big storm is approaching from west and expected to strike the city in a few hours. So close your windows and tie your car to a tree. And that's all for us.
Thank you. And have you ever seen this picture before? No, didn't think so.
That's all for us. Good night.
Okay, alright. But let me ask you this. What was the source of this? Why were you even in the conference room in the beginning?
We discussed if to bomb Russia and China.
Yes, of course I know that. But why were you even considering it?
Well, then we have to go further back in time. More precisely, to the 7th of June, 2011.
Me and my special force, with highly trained and brave soldiers, were sent on a secret mission to the Middle East.
Why were you sent there?
Secret mission, please! But it turned out to be more serious than we and the government expected. Accidentally, when we were out in the desert patrolling, we confronted the Taliban. He was nervous and tried to threaten us, but we were too many and we held him back. We felt immediately there was something queer with this guy, so we started to question him directly. But he wouldn't say a word. I, as a sergeant, then decided to take him in for a more serious interrogation and examination.
Examination?
Well, we needed to check if he was unarmed. Then we began a quite serious interrogation, which involved some torture. Unfortunately, the Taliban just became apathetic by our methods. But later on, after a couple of days, he eventually began to speak, and the information he had to tell us was quite appalling.
And what did he have to say?
He told us that his country had begun to produce and was hiding nuclear weapons, which we also later on found in the desert. Since he had told us about it, he said his life was in danger, and if it came out in the world, the whole Middle East was in peril, and the Third World War would be whispering in the wind. But they had a solution, and we reached an agreement after some more time. He revealed the pact signed by both Russia and China, which said that the two countries were planning to unite if the US would attack some of them. He couldn't tell us, though, where he'd get the paper from, but there it was, and it was authentic. The agreement involved that the US wouldn't tell about the nuclear weapons since we had the information about Russia and China, and otherwise were in great danger.
So that's why you were gathered in conference room?
Yes. The president considered all options possible. And 1 year later, he had come to a decision. But as you know, it all went wrong. And that's the truth. And no one survives the truth. Not even you.